Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Sacred Hearts Parish. We welcome those present here at church and also those attending Mass via live stream at home. My name is Diane Driscoll, and Bill Brenner and I will be have the privilege of being your electors today. We gather today as a community of believers to celebrate God's great gifts to us, God's Word, and the Eucharist. Today we celebrate the solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity. Our presider is Father John. Our Mass intention is for Edith Mazzaglia. Trinity Sunday is always the week following Pentecost. As we celebrated Jesus, the Son, throughout Easter and the Holy Spirit last week, this is the week to remember that our one God comprises three persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, equal in majesty and glory. In a spirit of hospitality, I invite you to now stand and greet those around you.
Please join in singing our opening song.
Let us now give praise and glory to our God.
Please join in singing our opening song, number 207, Holy, 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 number 207.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's been our prayer together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. My friends, the Lord be with you. We gather this beautiful summer afternoon to praise God, to thank God for the blessing of life, the gift of faith. We also acknowledge our faults and our failings. Let's now pause briefly, review our past week in our life, call to mind our sins, and welcome God's mercy and God's peace this day. Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let's praise our God together. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. God our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Ask now of the days of old, before your time, ever since God created man upon the earth. Ask for one end of the sky to the other. Did anything so great ever happen before? Was it ever heard of? Did a people ever hear the voice of God speaking from the midst of fire as you did and live? Or did any God venture to go and take a nation for himself from the midst of another nation? By testings, by signs, by wonders, by war, with strong hand and outstretched arm, and by great terrors, all of which the Lord your God did for you in Egypt before your very eyes. This is why you must now know and fix in your heart that the Lord is God in the heavens above and on the earth below, and that there is no other. You must keep his statutes and commandments that I enjoin on you today, that you and your children after you may prosper, and that you may have a long life on the land which the Lord your God is giving you forever." The word of the Lord.
Chosen to be his own. Blessed the people the Lord has chosen, chosen to be his own. Upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full. Blessed the people the Lord has chosen, chosen to be his own. Commanded and it stood forth. Blessed the people the Lord has chosen, chosen to be his own. See, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness, to deliver them from death. has chosen, chosen to be his own. Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us, who have put our hope in you. Chosen to be his own.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, for those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received a spirit of adoption, through whom we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if only we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. The word of the Lord.
Friends, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they all saw him, they worshiped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord. Hope you're all enjoying this holiday weekend, I guess, through early Monday. Some nice weather, then a little rain coming in, I guess. And today we as church, this weekend, celebrate this great feast of the Most Holy Trinity. And it's one of the three great feasts in this period of time in our calendar year. Last week was Pentecost. Today, Most Holy Trinity. And next weekend is Corpus Christi, the most holy body and blood of Jesus. So these three feast days are really the key elements of our church year to really help us embrace fully our Catholic life. One of the first phrases each one of us hears in our spiritual journey ties into our Trinity Sunday celebration when a priest or deacon baptized you. He would have said, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And so right then and there, we celebrate the Trinity. And every time you and I begin Mass, at the end of Mass, when the priest blesses you, we bless ourselves. So every time we bless ourselves in our Catholic life, we're also embracing the Trinity. And of course, it's easy for me to say the Trinity is a mystery, but more than that. There's three words, I think, play into this feast day this weekend. One is, of course, mystery. The other is transcendent. The other is imminent. And our goal, I think, in our spiritual journey is not to try to understand the Trinity, but to try our best to embrace relationship with the Trinity. We know Saint Patrick tried to use a shamrock to explain it. Another theologian, Saint Athanasius, tried to use the triangle as the Trinity. Rublev, a great Russian icon painter, had three angel figures around a table holding hands as the Trinity. So theologians, philosophers have tried their best to describe the Trinity. They could use very technical language describing, but it comes right down to each one of us trying to embrace who is the Trinity. It's all about relationships, how you and I encounter God in our life, our personal life, in the world. Today's first reading from Moses talking to the friends, he really is like a wake-up call. Folks, listen. Haven't you seen God's great work in your life? Wake up. Then he says to them a beautiful phrase, know and fix in your heart all that God has done for you. That's pretty powerful. So Moses is saying, folks, pay attention, get back on track, encounter God. God is great. God has blessed you. And then we hear in the Gospel today the phrase, I am with you always. That beautiful connection through the Old Testament and the New Testament, and how you and I are called to embrace that. So mystery. And I think it's so wise for us to identify the Trinity as mystery. If you and I had God all figured out, there'd be that less, desire maybe, that less, connection to a God that we know all about. You can go on Wikipedia or Google search and find out information from everybody in the world, their background, their history and all that, those people who made a claim in the world. But God is one of those figures, of course, divine being, sacred, holy, that is far beyond capturing in an essay, far beyond our human words can explain. I recall in seminary, we had to write an essay at the beginning part of our seminary training of who God is. We all scratched our head. Wow, that's a pretty big question. And so we all did our best, and the professor said, all well and good, but all you wrote there is just the snippets of the impression of God. God is far, far beyond. Mystery, transcendent, beyond this world, but desiring and deserving our attention. And that's why we're here today on this beautiful Saturday afternoon, because you desire to be close to God, to welcome God into your life, your heart, your spirit. You want to encounter mystery. You want to step from the known of this world, okay, go to work, if you're tired, your responsibilities, pay the bills, this summer have some fun time with your family, do this and that tonight. But when you come into our church here at St. Patrick's in Groveland, we really step into mystery, encountering God in this holy place For 100 years plus, people have come here searching for God, embracing God's presence in their life, mystery. And God is transcendent, but also I hope all of us can say imminent. God is with us. God is all around us. That great Jesuit understanding of God, finding God in all things, in all places, and at all times. It's a wonderful awareness to have in our life, God of all, and how we're calling to embrace that in our life. And as Catholics, next week, Corpus Christi, the gift of Eucharist, God with us. Amen, I believe you are here. I welcome you into my life. And so the Feast of the Holy Trinity is for us to come here, not to scratch our heads and understand it completely, we can't, but to embrace the relationship there of the Trinity with us, God as creator. Just sitting with that thought now, this beautiful world we have, who keeps this world in motion? You know, that old song we heard years gone by, he's got the whole world in his hands. I won't sing it for you, but I'm sure you know the tune. And that says so much. Who else is involved in creation of the world? Who keeps everything in order? 12 months a year, 52 weeks, 7 days, 24 hours. How can all that work? The seasons, you know, life, all our beautiful life we have, how everything works together. God. And God desired to create us. Now, if we were God-fearing people here, and to believe that our God, divine being, chose to create us, to share life with us. Isn't that awesome to embrace and to believe in, so we don't become so self-focused and selfish? It's all about me. You know, we hear the word often that some people's, the ego is too big. One person once told me, one older priest said, EGO, easing God out. If you're the center of everything, it's all about you, there's no room for God. If you have that awareness that God of creation, God of life, God of beauty, wow, that affects how you view life, how you embrace the fullness each day, and you're grateful for all you have. Yes, we have our intellect. We have our different gifts and talents. Some of you are physicians and nurses and firefighters and teachers and law people. We have all those gifts and business people. But we believe that all comes from God given to us. We have the motivation, the desire to live fully with God. And then, of course, God, the Savior, right? I always tell the kids when we gather here for Mass with the kids in the school and the Faith Formation Program, there's our story up there. Look at that beautiful stained glass window. The Nativity, look at the sun come through. That is reminding us all the time that God came into the world. God loves us to become one of us, to teach and heal and love. And so we embrace that message that God came into the world, sacred, holy, and taught us, forgave us, died on the cross, so that you and I might have a full life here and that hope of life beyond death. What a gift. And so we're called to embrace the fullness, and of course, Last Supper experience right there at this altar right here to receive Jesus. Then, of course, last week, Pentecost, the Holy Spirit came into the disciples' lives to empower them. We believe that the Spirit is all around us. Whenever you have felt that you did something, you say, how did I do that? How did I manage all my family responsibilities and went here, did that? Well, the Spirit was there to give you stamina and strength and motivation to give your best to your family, your friends, and you say, I don't know how sure I did it. Well, the Spirit was there to guide you and to love you. So my friends, today, this beautiful feast day, we're called to think about the mystery of the Trinity, the story of God's love in our life, and how we are called to embrace those aspects of the Trinity ourselves. How do we recreate the world, bring life into the world by our goodness? How do we follow the Lord's example to to be kind and generous and loving and caring for all people. How do we affirm people in our life, our youngsters? Good job, we're proud of you, you're doing a great job. Welcome home from college. Good luck in your first job, so forth and so on. Your friends, your family, we empower them to live life fully. So as we believe in the Trinity, we embrace the Trinity relationships, we're called to put into action their life. So I invite you in the coming weeks and months, as you bless yourself, believe that, and you come into church and bless yourself with holy water, remember your baptism, you'll leave in a few moments, blessing yourself again, back into the world. May the Lord guide you and the Trinity be with you. Truly embrace the fullness of God's love always and everywhere. So we come here often in our life to ask some questions. Who is God? Where is God? Do I believe? As we heard in the first reading, or the second reading, I believe, doubt. We have doubt. That's where the human mind gets into the whole mix of faith. But then we rise above that doubt. Yeah, creation. Yeah, story. Yeah, the Holy Spirit. And we trust, we believe, and we live with God in our life. May God bless us, my friends, today in this feast of the Most Holy Trinity. Look forward to next weekend, Corpus Christi, to come and praise God, receive Jesus, be truly blessed by his presence in our life always. Mystery, transcendence, immanence, all about relationship. How strong is your relationship with God? What has to change, be tweaked, be modified, deepened? Here is the place to do that, to carry this good news into your life and come to know God deeply in your spirit. May we now stand as you and I profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. For him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, where the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life, the world to come. As God's children, we now offer our prayers to our God this day.
That the church may be strengthened and sustained by the Holy Spirit in preaching the good news to all nations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For first responders, those in public safety, the military, and all those who put themselves in harm's way to protect us, that God may protect them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may comfort all who are lonely, and provide them with connection and community. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we who are gathered here and call God Father may experience the real presence of Christ in our lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died with Christ may share in his eternal glory, especially Daryl E. Johnson, Marie Olive LeBlanc, and George Lemieux. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Edith Mazzaglia, who is especially remembered at this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers and concerns we silently call to mind. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, Triune God, we thank you for the gift of life, your presence in our world, your gift this day. Help us always to shine forth goodness in the world and follow your example of loving and goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As the gifts are being presented, please join in singing number 549, Hymn of Praise, number 549.
To you, O Lord, our Father, alleluia. To you, the singer of creation's song, alleluia. With heart and hand and soul and voice, to you
Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice, and yours, O God, the Almighty Father, may the Lord the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church. Sanctified by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. My friends, the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. With your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord. Not in the unity of a single person, but in the trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit. So that in the confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too, and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as in one voice we pray together.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was entered the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Dear Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, the clergy, religious, and all your faith-filled people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. We pray this day for Edith Bazaglia and all deceased loved ones and friends, Memorial Day weekend. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we are always free from sin and safe from all distress of life, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. My friends, the peace of the Lord be with you always. Now turn to our family, our friends, and offer the sign of peace. My friends, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be. The blood of Christ.
Our communion song today is number 475, "Eye Has Not Seen," number 475. Teach us the wisdom of God. Please join in our meditation song, number 707, Hail Mary, Gentle Woman, number 707.
A special welcome to Deacon Brian Daly, who begins his summer internship this week at Sacred Hearts. He was ordained a deacon by Cardinal Sean on Saturday, May 4th. He will be with us throughout the summer and on weekends during the school year. Next weekend, the Catholic Daughters are collecting items needed by our local veterans. Please see the bulletin for a complete list of items. Faith formation registration for the fall is now open. Please visit sacredheartsparish.com/kids to download the form. Vacation Bible School will be held the weekend of June 17th. We are seeking teen and adult volunteers to help and to attend a mandatory mentors retreat on Sunday, June 9th at 10 a.m. More information is in the bulletin. Father's Day spiritual bouquet cards are available in the back of the church. Please write the name of your father or another special man who you would like us to pray for this Father's Day.
Thank you, Bill, for that parish news. I want to thank all involved in today's liturgy to be with us today. Wish you all a wonderful, restful weekend. Let's pray for our deceased loved ones to bring them into our heart this weekend and commit them to God, especially weekend to do that. And stay well, stay healthy. Let's now stand for our final prayers. Let us pray. May receive in this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord. Amen. My friends, the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God. Have a good night. See you next week.
Please join in singing our closing song, number 745, America the Beautiful, number 745.
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of gray, for purple mountain majesties above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. Oh, beautiful for pilgrim feet who stern in passion stress, a thoroughfare for freedom beat across the wilderness.